Tons of food rejected by supermarkets or past its sell-by date ends up at this food bank distribution center on the outskirts of Brussels. From here it will find its way to thousands of poor families in the Belgian capital. Despite a decline in the rate of inflation in the eurozone from its peak of more than 11.5% in 2022 to 2.9% at the end of last year, food prices have remained high and millions of Europeans are struggling.
The number of people we help is constantly increasing. Not by too much, I mean a few percent each year, but it's a real trend.
Vegetables, dairy products and bread for more than 30,000 poor people delivered here every day. With poverty levels going up in many European countries, more and more people are depending on food donations, turning what started as small handouts into a well-oiled industry of free food.
With attacks on ships in the Red Sea, fears that the Gaza war could escalate in the Middle East, and energy prices remaining high after Russia's invasion of Ukraine, hopes of economic relief this year are being dashed. The European Central Bank maintaining a hold on interest rates is keeping borrowing costs high and demands for loans low. That's expected to dampen growth in the eurozone to less than half of 1%.
I think the European economy is somehow stuck in stagnation. It's not a severe recession, but it is a minor stagnation. When we also look at leading indicators, there are no signs of an imminent improvement.
Not a great prospect for both sellers and buyers at local markets, where business has been slow for over a year.
Especially now, with the problems in the Red Sea, ships have to make large diversions, so transport costs are higher and our goods will become even more expensive. For us, it's a twofold problem with customers already buying less. As a trader, it has become hard to make a living.
With a record low unemployment rate of 6.4%, it's expected that workers around Europe will demand large pay rises this year, something that could push up prices even more. Another reason for Europe's Central Bank, which is aiming for an inflation rate of 2% by next year, to not take any chances. While many Europeans hope for better and cheaper times soon, economists say it's hard to predict when or if that time will come. Step Fasten, Al Jazeera, Brussels.
Make sure to subscribe to our channel to get the latest news from Al Jazeera.